Hey guys, it's Michaela. Welcome back to another video. And if you're new, you know what to do. Subscribe. Okay, so today I'm going to be doing a first impressions kind of video with makeup that I've never used before. Some of these things I have to admit, I kind of used already. Just because I'm late making this video and I needed something to use. So I've got a couple of things here that are drugstore and a couple of things that are high-end that I've gotten as a gift or that I just bought. So let's start. I already moisturized my face, so I'm going to prime with Smashbox photo finish primer. I don't know if you could have seen that, my lights are kind of bright, but yeah, first thing I'm gonna do is prime. This feels like velvet. I don't know how much I'm supposed to use. Is it weird I didn't use primer before? Like, I'm just now using primer. So I'm kind of scared. I'm just putting like a dime size. Not a dime size. I don't know how much this is, but I'm going to use my ring fingers because I don't know how to use this stuff. Whoa. It like instantly went into my skin. My skin feels so smooth. Wow, I kind of want to use more. I don't know if I'm supposed to use that much, but wow, and it makes it instantly matte. Oh my god. I like the way this feels. Okay, I'm a fan. I like the Smashbox photo finish primer. I guess it's drying down now. I mean, it was already like dry when I put it on. It's just like velvety feeling. Like, I don't know how to explain it. So next thing I'm gonna do is go in with my new NARS. But this is a new one. It's the NARS Radiant Longwear Foundation. Natural Radiant. I like it. I've already used it because your girl needed a new foundation. I was using these freaking Fenty samples and I just could not find my shade. At first it was 370 and then I realized it was oxidizing, kind of orangey, like dark on me. So then I went to 350 because someone else suggested that and I was like more olivey tone. So yeah, now I'm using 350, but it's not as full coverage, and since I've been breaking out, I kind of need that full coverage right now. So I'm gonna go with this. It's claiming to be full coverage and it lasts a long time. It's a long wear foundation. If you want me to test this out, just let me know, because I can do another video testing this out. I'm not gonna come back at the end of this video and like show you 10 hours later, because it's already like 3 o'clock. So if you want me to do actual foundation test, then just let me know. But I'm gonna use 3 pumps. I don't know if I should do it on my face or not, because I also got this new e.l.f. sponge and it's kind of hard. Like, I mean, it may not look like it's hard, but when I was putting it on my face, I'm like, this thing feels like I'm beating rock against my skin. Like, I don't know. I really like how this matches my backdrop. Ew, I don't know if you can see this, but it looks so wrinkly now. I think I'm just gonna do it on my face. So one pump here, one pump here, a baby pump here, and one pump here. I don't know if this is a lot, but I'm gonna spread it out a little bit. Okay. Okay, I see that it is not taking away the coverage. So obviously it's not matching my forehead right now. My forehead is just naturally darker than the rest of my skin, so I'm gonna go in with my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer because it's a little bit darker than my skin. I don't know if you could tell, but I put it on my forehead. So the next thing I'm gonna do is conceal under my eyes, and I normally never do this, but I'm gonna be a little extra today. I'm gonna start highlighting, like, you know, my forehead and conceal under there, the bridge of my nose, whatever. I'm gonna be using Tarte Shape Tape Concealer, and Don't come for me. I already know the tea about Tarte right now, and I bought this like before all of this happened with the foundation. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just YouTube Tarte Shape Tape foundation review. You'll find out a lot of things. But yeah, I'm gonna use it today. I'm not promoting Tarte Shape Tape or the foundation or anything like that. I just simply bought it before all of this hullabaloo started. I would like to see how it uses. I've never actually had one before. Oh my gosh, I'm excited. This is what it looks like. I don't know why I'm showing you like you've never seen it before. If you watch any, if you've watched any other YouTuber do makeup and whatnot, like, pretty sure you've seen this before. It's nothing new, it's nothing special. I'm just real late to the game. And this looks very thick. Like, I cannot get it to the top of the bottle. Oh my. I don't know how this is gonna look on my skin. It has like a peachy undertone. I just went by Alyssa Ashley because I know me and her twin sister Arnell have the same color. In the NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation, we both wear Tahoe. I was just going by that. So I don't know how it's gonna look. I'm just gonna dot. This is the YouTube way of putting on concealer, so I'm just gonna use my beauty blender and blend that out. I don't think it's supposed to look like this. Wow, I like it. And it made it look very flawless. And now for the other eye. These lights have me so messed up. And I probably look extra crazy without my eyebrows filled in. But that's what we're gonna do next. I bought MUA. I bought a stippling brush. I guess I could still like... Wow, that got dirty quick. It's alright. I don't really need it like that. But I have a smaller stippling brush I can use for like blush or like contour. And this one is by e.l.f. I guess I could use this for contour. But I'm gonna use this to bake my eyelids. Just taking the Maybelline powder. Set in my eyelids. Wipe away the creases first. Okay, so now that I look like a ghost, I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows. I don't have any new eyebrow products, so I'm just gonna do the same old, what I normally do to fill in my eyebrows. This powder gets really messy really fast. Eat your vitamins, kids, even if they're gummies. But I'll be right back. Okay. I did my brows. And I look a little bit crazy right now, but I promise you it's just because my lashes are looking like invisible. So next thing, I'm going to go back into the face and I'm gonna use this Milani Baked Bronzer. It look like this. I'm scared though because this looks like a blush to me. Oh look, comes with a mirror and a little applicator brush. How cute. No, sorry, but no. Mm-mm. So I'm gonna go back in with the stippling brush. Oh, do y'all see that? It cakes up fast. She's shiny, all right. Screw that, I'm gonna take my fluffy angle brush. It's like for blush, but I'm gonna use it for my Bronte today. I can't really tell. I think it looks cute, it's a cute bronzer. It's kind of shimmery. Do we like it? Are we liking it? Or it's pretty red though, I'm not gonna lie. And the shimmer, I don't like it on my forehead because my forehead already fat. I don't need a fatter forehead or fatter looking forehead because the bronzer shimmery. So I look like I'm wearing a wig, but I promise you, sis, it's not a wig. I'm just lazy with my hair lately. But it's clean. But this bronzer, I think it would be really pretty if I were wearing no makeup. You know what I'm saying? Like, these type of bronzers, I feel like they look better when you have a fresh face. Not when you got a full face and it's like looking like, I don't know how to explain it. But I like it. It's red. It's red looking. But I like it. I will keep it. I also got this Milani Baked Blush, which I probably shouldn't have because this bronzer is already a blush. But you know me, SAGE. My camera just died. I don't know when it stopped recording, but I was in the middle of talking. I know that. But next thing I'm gonna do is apply this Baked Blush by Milani. Got it from CVS. They have another brush in here, but like, girl, this brush is like so thick and like, I don't know how I feel about that, but we're not using that. Sorry, but no. So I'm going to go in with the same brush for the blush, and it's the Baked Blush by Milani, so it's gonna have like a cute, oh! That escalated so quickly. Well, good thing I like blush because, girl, that is pigmented. I just tapped it once. I just look like, oh my gosh. I look like a little kid that just played in their mom's makeup, like the blush. It's a little crazy. I'm gonna have to tone it down a bit. I'm gonna take my MAC Studio Fix Plus thing. But you need to calm down. Okay, so I bet you already know what I'm using for highlight. I'm gonna use my Fenty Beauty Matchstick and Tripping, and I'm going to just like lightly glide it on my cheekbone. It looks like a straight line right now, but I'm gonna blend it out and I'm gonna use another highlight on top. But then I'm gonna use this Fenty Beauty and I'm gonna take my fan brush and I'm going to blend this out a little bit. And I'm so truly sorry if you read the title and it said affordable makeup, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, this Fenty Beauty ain't that affordable. If you're just getting one thing, it is. But if you're getting like the whole line, nah, girl, you're gonna be broke. So, yeah. And then I'm just going over top of it with Chic Freak. Yes, and then, yeah. So it looks kind of blushy. Once I do my eyes, it won't look as crazy, I promise you. So far, the set for this, for my eyes when I set them earlier, it's not staying so well. Like, I can still see a baby crease. It's not terrible, but it's supposed to be set. I'm gonna take a little bit of this Baked bronzer and I'm going to put it on my eyelid because I'm gonna use this as a transition shade, kind of. Okay, so my grandmother bought me this makeup thing. I don't know who it's by, but it looks like this. Yeah, and so she bought me this. It comes with three different palettes. Okay, and this is the pink one. They come with little applicator brushes, but you know we ain't gonna be needing that. So I'm gonna take this one with the pink palette. I don't know what to call them. They don't have names, but like I showed you the box. So if you wanted to buy it, I think it's at Macy's. I'm gonna put that one on my lid. And I didn't really spray or anything before I put this on here. I should have, but I didn't. That's okay. Subtle is pretty. Okay, I think that's enough of this palette. I'm not really feeling all the colors in there. You know what? Taking my finger because they want to play me. It's too white. Like, I feel like all these colors come out looking the same. Is that just me? But like, when you buy a palette like this and you put it on, it's like all the colors look the same. It's like this one could be pink, but it just has like a little pink undertone. Like, it doesn't really look pink. Yeah, see, it's not gold. It's literally white. Like, they're all the same. What is that? Like, what's the point? What is the point? Okay, I'm done using this palette. I'm gonna go in with my Oakalon matte one just because I love all the colors in this one. I'm going with Creation in the crease like I always do. That's not new. But hey, I don't know why, but this is turning out pink and I said I didn't want any more pink because my whole face is pink right now. Now I'm gonna go in with my Laura Geller highlight like you already know. put that in the center of all of those two. My brow bone highlight is just gonna be super popping today. And not even intentionally, it's just starting to turn out that way. And then I'm gonna put this in, what is this called? My nose? The tip of my nose? Okay, I look crazy without lashes, so I think that's the next thing we're gonna do. I think I'm going to do a liner, but I'm not sure. I might just do a shadow liner, like always. Too lazy to actually do a liner. And this palette I'm using is the dupe naked palette that I got online at Amazon. This video is a disaster. I don't really like the way this is turning out. For one, my forehead looks super shiny and like I can't really do nothing about that. Two, this bronzer was a little too red for me personally. Three, this sponge right here did not apply my foundation the way I like it to be applied. Oh yeah, and I totally forgot. I got this brow gel because I've been talking about how I need a brow gel. I got this from Sally's. It's called Perfect Arch Clear Brow Gel. I didn't even put it on, but I like it. It's like keeping my hairs in place, but not making them feel too stiff at the same time. Like, I like it. And I know I'm applying it after I already put my brow stuff on, but like, that's how I like to apply it. If I do it before, my brows are like stuck in place already, and then I don't really know how I'm drawing them on, you know? Like, I don't know how my shape is gonna look. I don't know, I just like to do it after. Okay, now that my brows are set in place, I'm going to apply some mascara. Same one, Lash Sensational by Maybelline from the drugstore. And it might be weird, but I'm only gonna put lashes on the top. I'm not gonna do my bottom lashes today just because I kind of want that concealer and whatnot to like pop through from within. So the lashes I'm gonna be using is these. Okay, now I'm waiting for these to dry and I'm gonna apply some inner corner highlight. You thought I forgot. Yes, and I'm going to be using this Moon Dust by Urban Decay in the color Recharged. Throughout this video, I've been getting more and more, or less and less enthusiastic because I'm not feeling confident about how this is looking. Maybe in different lighting, I'll feel better, but like right now, I don't know. Like, this is so gross to me. It's like uncomfortable, making me uncomfortable, literally. And for lips, since my lips have been crusty this whole time, it's like a natural nude for me. It doesn't have anything on it. I don't know where it's from. It's just blank. Whew, okay. Got my lashes on. Got my lip liner on, but my lips are peeling and whatnot right now. So sorry if this looks disgusting to you, but I don't know what my arms were doing just then. I was just stretching kind of. What? Want to be in the video? You're always in the video. Look at the camera. Boy. But yeah, I guess this is the look. I guess. Like, oh no. I'm not done. This is eyeshadow. I was about to take a liquid eyeshadow and put on my lips. I need help. So I'm gonna take my Fenty Beauty gloss balm. I messed that up too many times. Kinda, I'm a little bit tempted to put this on my eyelid, on my eyelids. Okay, don't know what I was expecting, but plot twist. Haha. Yeah, this is most definitely a plot twist. Like, last second, I think I'm gonna do a glossy eye. Wow, the gloss got on my lashes and now I look like one of those cheap Dollar Tree hoes. No, that's not cute, honey. Okay, now I'm just gonna add a little bit of eye mascara. There we go. Now I think I'm completely done. Don't know why I'm doing this stupid accent. It's not really stupid. I love people from London or England or whatever. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. This was kind of a fail, kind of not. I don't know, you tell me below if you think it was a fail or you think I came out successful, whatever. I don't know. But thank you guys for watching. Nonetheless, comment down below any video ideas you want me to do. And yeah, I'll try to execute those for you. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to do my hair in two high buns because it's way cuter. Way cuter. Oh, if I can get it right. If you're going to do two buns, why not do them high up like Mickey Mouse? Come inside my playhouse. Why am I still doing this accent? My hair's so greasy. First day hair is not cute, girl. I'm finally done.